Hello everyone, in the present video I am going to give you an idea about clinical practice improvement points to consider for physiotherapist. If you are a physiotherapist in India, then you might be running your own clinic, working in some physiotherapy clinic, working in physiotherapy department of any hospital which may be a government or a private hospital, working in physiotherapy OPD or in hospital which has tie up with academic institute, doing home visits or a home care. You might be working with the home care agencies like a portier, and maybe you are getting patients from Plato, India Heartbeat, Light Rate, Just Dial, etc. Now, if you are really interested to improve your clinical practice in terms of quality of treatment and number of patients, then you need to find out the ways of monitoring and improving the quality of care. Think of taking an informed consent from the patient. Do proper complaint management. Take the complaints from the patient as a point to improve in your present system of working. The third point is conduct the patient satisfaction survey to know where you stand in the patient management and try to improve. And the fourth important point which you can do is peer practice review. How other therapists or clinics near to your area is getting the patient and how they are maintaining and improving the quality of care, that you should know by visiting them or by having a conversation with them, okay, so that you will get an idea about, okay, how to improve. So don't forget, change is the only thing which is constant in our life, and always accept the positive changes. Let us see. In the clinical setup, there is a strong need to work continuously to improve the quality of treatment. And for that, what you can do is you can think about making use of evidence-based clinical standard policy, protocols and guidelines for treating your patient, so that improve your standard of practice. Now, today I am going to give you an idea about 14 important points which you need to consider. First point is always focus on patient-centered care. Think about the patient's need for the treatment, concern and expectation from the treatment, and treat the patient. Second point, save time for you as well as for patient. We all have a limited time in a day. So save the time for both of you, that means your patient and as well as for you, by giving appropriate result oriented treatment. Okay, so you can treat more number of patients, at the same time you no need to compromise on quality of treatment. Let us see the third point, that is be responsive to patient care. Always be responsive and responsible for the treatment which you are giving. Point number four, in clinical administration, make the system transparent and always provide the information which patient wants from you. Number five, just suppose you are introducing a new service at your clinic, then periodically you need to evaluate whether it is utilized fully or not. Okay, it has helped to improve your number of patients at OPD, yes or no. Okay, and last part, sixth point is, if required, try to give patient-friendly scheduling. Now, let us try to understand how to evaluate the new services. So, through this table, I would like to explain. Just suppose you can make and just suppose you have started offering this seven different new techniques or equipments at your clinic through which you have started giving the treatment. So just suppose you are giving treatment, you started a service by giving extracorporeal shockwave. So make a documentation of it, that on 1st of July 2019, how many times you have given. If you have introduced FES, okay, functional electrical stimulation, how many times you have given. Long wave diathermy, microwave diathermy, laser, spinal decompression system, eccentric resistance training, etc. So write it down how many times per day you have given. And this documentation, you can do it in the physical form, that means you can make a new register and maintain it. At the same time, you can do a digital documentation in the form of a Microsoft Word or Excel, etc., to know every day that how these services are utilized at your clinic, So you will get an idea about the utilization of the service and further expansion of the services. Now let us see the remaining 7 points. Work on to improve your phone and appointment services. So try to improve and be little patient friendly, okay, in receiving the phone and giving the proper appointment. Next point is implement clear payment guidelines. Okay, so if required, so you can do is you can make use of debit card, credit card, UPI, etc. That system you can make it available at your clinic. That is also a form of a change. If patient demands, you can go for this type of payment mode also. Ninth point is enhance the documentation. Very, very important, both in physical as well as digital way. It will be easy to decide later on, like whether the patient is improving, not improving, or patient in a status quo state. And you can retrieve the patient's information and the details if they have forgotten the OPD card at clinic. And very important is documentation adds value to your treatment. It is very, very important, even from the medico-legal point of view, and even for having a communication with the other healthcare providers as well. Let us see the 10th point. Be prudent or clear when hiring the staff at your clinic. I always say tell, teach and train them as per the need of the industry. 11th point, estimate the overtime for your clinical as well as ground or clerical staff. Why? Because it's like a catalyst for them to work with the more commitment. So that should be based on the some monetary or some incentive base of provide them. It's not only just a appreciation with the word, but you need to pay the money as well. And the next point is also related to this only, establish an incentive system. So what will happen, apart from the salary, they will get the extra money so that the staff will run to work and your monitoring will reduce like anything. Let us see the point number 13 and 14. The 13th point, it says learn the art of managing the situation. So in clinical practice, you must have experience few days or the months you may have too many patients at your clinic, and few days, especially festivals days, strike, natural or man-made calamities, you may not have many patients, or sometimes you don't have patient also. So when you don't have patient, what to do? When you have patient, how to manage and how to plan accordingly? That art or the skill you need to develop. And the last point and important is delegate. See, we have a limited number of hours in a day, so we can't do all the work by our own. Give opportunity to your subordinates to work as well, so they can also learn the art of managing the things. So I hope this video will add few drops of information in your knowledge. Good luck and thank you for watching the video. Thank you.